U4 Video 3, Manifest Destiny. We're going to start out with a quick video clip that, you know, if I was monetized, I would get demonetized, but you can't get monetized when you don't make money.
Dictate, Marshal?
Nope.
Any last words?
Nope.
What do you want on your tombstone?
Pepperoni and cheese.
Time for Tombstone Pizza, made with the good stuff. Real pepperoni, real cheese, so it's always real good. What do you want on your tombstone?
Just a little taste.
Nope.
Provided with absolutely no context. So before our Manifest Destiny moment, remember we've got the French in the western area of Louisiana, which we're going to purchase. We talked about that in previous videos. And then the Spanish own still the Southwest. We bought this land, Louisiana, purchase from the French. It's ours, but the Southwest still belongs to the Spanish and then eventually the government of Mexico. Manifest destiny is this belief during the 1800s or the 19th century that God granted us the land from the Atlantic Ocean to the Pacific Ocean. It is ours to take. It is ours to civilize. And God says it's okay if we murder a bunch of people and steal their land. Shouldn't laugh. Genocide, ethnic cleansing, and then we use faith and this idea that God told us to. So that's the bad part. But it is good that, you know, America exists today. And if we wouldn't have done this, then half of the country would not exist. So I don't know. Why? Whatever. It's imperialism. All right, I get it, Howard Zinn. You want to teach every American kid to hate America. All right, we've done it. We've said that, yes, it's imperialism. We stole land from the Spanish. We stole land from the Mexicans. We stole land from the French. We stole land from the English. We stole land from the American Indians, and we murdered a lot of people. Great. Let's go ahead and teach it that way so that everyone will grow up to hate America. Check. We have done that. Congratulations. Maybe we can like teach it the other way where we don't like hate America for 5 seconds. Maybe we can like, hey, you know what? Yeah, some bad things happen, but some good things happen too. Maybe we can look at, no, it's imperialism. The world's a terrible place. We're all evil. All right. We're all evil. We're all terrible. Okay. Well, just thanks. Thanks, Howard. Thanks, Howie. Anyway, so we're going to move west. Wow, look at this map, the expansion of the United States. Manifest destiny from sea to shining sea, the Atlantic Ocean to the Pacific Ocean. 50 great states and building this nation. Wow, look at all that change. That's going to be Americans moving west. Yeah, there's some bad things that happen. We'll talk about those in other videos. You know about those problems. I'm not saying they didn't happen. I'm not saying there weren't mistakes being made. But also don't want to just constantly, you know, kick dirt in the face of America. It's okay to be kind of happy that these states exist and that our lives exist. Anyway, manifest destiny is the idea that God said, go conquer that land, civilize that land, advance the society, advance civilization, spread democracy. Yeah, you can say, oh, some bad things happen, but we also will spread democracy. We will spread equality. Well, how can you have equality if you're murdering people? I know. I get it, Howard Zinn. I get it. Imperialism. People were treated unfairly. It happened. But we're trying to live up to an ideal today. We're trying to spread democracy today. We're trying to spread opportunity and equality today. And we can't do that today if that didn't happen then. But it was bad. I get it. Manifest destiny. We conquer. The Americans conquer North America, at least the United States portion. You can see the different routes. Lewis and Clark will be first, followed by the Santa Fe Trail will be blazed, then the Oregon Trail, the Pony Express, and then eventually the Transcontinental Railroad will connect the Atlantic Ocean to the Pacific Ocean. I should do it this way. Atlantic Ocean to the Pacific Ocean. People will spread. Ideas will spread. Democracy will spread. Equality will spread. Opportunity will spread. The quality of life will grow. Health standards will grow. Education levels will grow. Everything in the end will improve. Yeah, but I know this land used to belong to someone else. And before then, it belonged to someone else. And before them, it belonged to someone else. And before them, it belonged to someone else. And guess what? Someone will probably steal this land from us because we deserve it. Right, Howard Zinn? So we deserve to have our land taken from us. And when the aliens come, I will say, look, we had it coming, man. We had it coming. This is alien manifest destiny. Anyways, back in reality, let's talk about the Oregon Trail. So the Oregon Trail is this famous passage of Americans overcoming adversity, overcoming physical obstacles, overcoming physical nature to find opportunity, to create opportunity for themselves. No one gave it to them. No one handed it to them. They had to face all kinds of natural, physical, human obstacles to get this chance. And they did 2,000 miles through the mountains, a 5-month journey. It's one thing to do that on your own. It's another thing to do that with your family, taking care of your kids, going through the mountains, feeding them, surviving to find this opportunity. It's pretty amazing from that perspective, isn't it? It's pretty amazing the human achievement that went into starting these states. We think of Oregon like it's always existed. This Oregon was created by human beings that overcame nature, that overcame adversity to build cities from nothing, to build opportunities from nothing. They were willing to take the ultimate sacrifice to risk not only their lives, but their family's life for just one chance. And they didn't know what was on the other end. They didn't know what they were going to get. They have an idea. They have a hope. They have an optimism. There is a promise, but they don't know. But they were willing to give up their life, to sacrifice their life for that chance. That is pretty amazing. And we have that happening today with immigrants coming into our country as well. So there is a parallel there. There is a human spirit. There is a American spirit, an exceptionalism, an American dream. How about that, Howard Zinn? And then there's a video game that lets you live through this, and it's pretty awesome. Your parents played this video game in school. It's the only video game we ever were allowed to play in school. Probably grandparents now. Like, yeah, that's black and white. Where's the color in that picture? What is that thing I'm looking at? Ew, that is gross. You're right. Parents, grandparents. It's probably grandparents. Maybe even great-grandparents for some of you. But it was awesome. It allowed us to experience history and understand history and know our history, embrace our history, and be proud of some of our history. It's okay to be ashamed and embarrassed by some of the things our founding fathers and Americans have done. And it's okay at the same time to be proud of some of their achievements too. I'm not saying we should be 100% exceptionalism, that we're the best, but I also don't think we need to go the Howard Zinn route of hating life and being depressed and crying all day. You can cry a little and you can be happy too. We can experience the whole spectrum of emotions. So here are some of the examples. This is an awesome game. You got to hunt. You had to make decisions about fording the river or just going across the river or going around. But that's going to take 5 days. And if we take too many days on the journey, we're going to get hit and stuck in the winter and we're going to freeze to death. And you will freeze to death. You will die. I need to play the game again to see if I can beat it. But I have one student who beat the game. And you can almost barely even say they beat the game. They made it to Oregon, but their entire family was dead. You're like, what kind of game is this? It's a game where everyone dies. Because the video game makers didn't want to sugarcoat history. They wanted to tell you how it was. Guess what, folks? Thousands of miles through the mountains on a wagon? It's not a family vacation. You're gonna die. Maybe you live, maybe you don't. The Americans that survived and built Oregon should be honored. They overcame great obstacles. And I have that feeling because I lived through it through a terrible, this is an awesome video game. You should play the video game. Everybody dies, right? Here's Stephanie. When you die, you get to do a tombstone. How cool is that? Forget about reading books and doing math today. I'm burying my family. What would you like on your tombstone? Pepperoni and cheese. It's all coming together now. So the Oregon Trail, it's pretty awesome. It's imperialism. Howie Zinn, you're ruining my childhood. Is that what you want to do? Is that the whole plan here? You're just going to make me not only hate America, but you also want me to hate my childhood too. Great. Awesome. Thanks. Congratulations, Howard. Congratulations. I hate everyone and everything. I'm done. Should I just get out of here? Or I still got a couple slides left, so let's just move on. All right, let's talk about some more imperialism. I mean, technically, you could say, well, these countries, that's imperialism. They stole the land from Spanish, who stole the land from the American Indians. And guess what? So Spanish steal the land from the American Indians. You could say the Mexicans steal the land from the Spanish, couldn't you? And then guess what? We're going to steal the land from them. And then the aliens eventually will set everything straight until the next level of aliens conquer those aliens. And, I mean, we stole the land from the dinosaurs. Everybody knows that. So remember the Monroe Doctrine? The Spanish, the European imperialists have been kicked out, or colonists, colonialists have been removed, and they're not allowed coming back. And also, we're not going to go over there. Yeah, right. That's part of the Monroe Doctrine. I didn't talk about that the other day. One of the parts is, you can't come over here, and we won't go over there. Yeah. Yeah, we're not going to go over and get involved in European wars. That's rich. Anyway, so Mexico, Brazil, Ecuador, all these countries are free and they start democracies and it's a pretty much a disaster. But nonetheless, they are, I guess, a little bit better off. So in Mexico, Mexico's ruled by Santa Ana. They've got their own thing going on and they're trying to build up their country just like us. And one of the things they do is they send us a personal invitation saying, you guys can move into America, or you can move over into Freudian slip. You can move into Texas, which still belongs to Mexico. Come on in. You're cool. You can settle here. You can live with us. Our borders are open. Move into our nation. Build farms in our nation. Help us grow our nation. You're more than welcome. And the future Texans come in like, all right, cool. I'm just going to bring my slaves. They're like, whoa. No. We go into slavery here. Come on in. But you're going to need to leave the slavery at home. You know, no slavery here. We are not believing in bondage. We do not believe you can keep humans in chains. So come on in, and but don't bring the slaves. Oh, also, you've got to be Catholic too. And at that point, the Texans are like, yeah, you know what? We're going to come, and we're going to bring the slaves, and we're not going to be Catholic. So, and the next is like, well, you can't do that. This is our government. This is our nation. Here are our rules. And the Texans get indignant and upset, like, you can't tell us what to do. Yeah, we can. This is our country. We invited you here. We have rules. You can't come into our country. But the Texans aren't hearing it. The Texans are like, no, we're going to move into your country, and we're going to live by our rules, and let's see what you're going to do about it. And so they have a war. They have the Texas War, and it's basically over expansion. One of the more famous battles is here in Gonzales, Texas, where the Texans have a cannon, and the Mexicans are like, look, dude, you can't have this cannon. You need to hand the cannon over. You people are out of your mind with your weapons. And the Texans basically fly a flag saying, come get it. Come take it. Come take it. And they don't take it. Another famous battle is going to be the Alamo, where Texans are going to lose. This is, oh, well, that's not good. But it serves as a rallying cry. And there's a lot of history and mythology around it. You want to read about it. But the big point is the Alamo serves as a rallying cry to get all of Texas amped up and to say those rotten, terrible, evil other country. I don't want to say what enemy. And so eventually the Texans will defeat the Mexican army and Texas will become its own thing. And this Alamo served as a rallying point really throughout American history now. And Texas is its own place. Cool, end of story. Well, not really, because America's expanding and America sees Texas, and Texas is its own nation, the Republic of Texas. It's not Mexico. It's not America. We're like, well, why don't we just make it a part of America? Because the people living there are Americans and they have all the same beliefs, the ideas, they speak the same language. Why don't we just make it a part of America, right? Let's expand. Let's bring Texas in and let's make it a slave state so we can get more slave state representatives and make more slave state laws. That's a great idea. Good job, James K. Polk. Right, it's all about getting more representatives, and you're going to get more senators if you have more states. So, oh, Texas, that's definitely a slave state. Bring them in, bring them in. Well, here's the problem. Mexico's like, no, this is still ours. Yeah, we lost a couple of battles, but there's no Republic of Texas. That's still Mexican land. What are you doing? You can't just add it as a state. You can't just bring it in. It's still ours. Like, right, we just let a couple people in. We had a little bit of war, but it's still our land. So folks are like, I want to settle this. Rock, it's yours. Scissors, we go to war. And we go to war, and it's a very quick war, the Mexican-American War, and the Mexicans are absolutely destroyed. And you can see all this land. Now, we do send them some cash after the fact to pay for this land, but come on, they weren't really wanting to sell it. No one sells land. But you do sell land when there's a gun to your head, like, all right, I don't have a choice, do I? You've got a gun to my head. You're going to give me $50? All right, I guess I'll take $50, you know. So, I mean, look at all these states that are ceded to America. Now we're going to decide what we're going to do with all these states here in the Southwest. And the big question is, are those going to be slave states? More slave states means more representatives, means more laws pro-slavery. We're going to have to decide. The Treaty of Guadalupe Hidalgo will end the Mexican-American War. This will cede this land. We'll give some cash to them as well. But the Southwest exists today because of the Mexican-American War. You get a little bit of cash. If you get a chance, read Blood Meridian. amazing book, brilliant book. I'll just wait for the movie. They'll never make this into a movie. Trust me. When you read this, you're like, yeah, you can't do that in the movie. That's pretty out there. An amazing book that'll really give you a fun understanding. Well, not fun, a dark understanding of time. So we have this issue, but what are we going to do about Southwest slavery, not slavery? Well, the representative Wilmot will say, well, I've got the Wilmot Proviso, which is basically just his plan, and says, all right, here's what we're going to do. No slavery in the Southwest. That's the Wilmot Proviso. And the government says, no, we're not going to do that. Cool story, bro. At the same time, we're moving west. Why? Because gold is discovered in California. So all these things are happening at the same time. We're winning the war. We're trying to figure out what to do with the Southwest. California becomes a state like that, huh? Well, when you find gold, everyone rushes to California. You need 50,000 people to become a state, right? That's why it takes Ohio, Indiana, these Northwest states a while before they become states, because you got to slowly move people in. Well, there's no slowly moving people in. Everyone loves the elephant, Jeff. There's no slowly moving in. It's like, oh, they found gold. See ya. And then all of a sudden, overnight, 50,000 people in California. Well, what do you do with California? 1848, it's not even there. 1850, it's already a state. And California is a slave state. Or nah. What do we do? Look, it's right in the middle. Half of it's free. Half of it's south of the freedom line described by the Missouri Compromise. What do you do? It's in the middle. What do you do? Well, California's like, don't worry about it. We already decided we're going to be free. Wait, what? Yeah, we decided. We said we were going to be free. But there's a Missouri Compromise, and you're above it or you're below it. And we got these rules, and the government and the slave states are supposed to say. And the slaves are like, what? No. We need more slave states. You guys can't make this decision on your own. The people can't decide for themselves. We, the slave states, get to decide. Or the federal government gets to decide. You don't get to make up rules on your own, like letting the people decide. What do you think? Is this a democracy? This is not a democracy, folks. We rule. We make the decisions. At least let Wilmot decide, or the government decide, or the Missouri Compromise decide, or some other compromise. You can't just decide for yourself. To be continued, we will decide. But ultimately, now that California is going to be a free state, the balance is thrown. Oh no, what are we going to do? I don't know, maybe outlaw slavery? Well, something's going to have to happen. To be continued, we'll see in the next episode. But where we're leaving right now, free states are in the lead. Let's see if they can hang on to that lead in the second half.